This clip is brought to you by SaveWithConrad.com.
Let's remind everybody that she's dedicated her life to fitness early on. We even talked about that, you know, while she's in high school, she didn't realize she had a tumor, but once she finishes high school, she starts entering fitness competitions. In 96, even she competed in the New York City regional level of the Fitness America competition. And because of her large size compared to the other women, she usually finished in last place, but you know where that won't be the case? Pro wrestling. She begins a mission to find a famed wrestler, Killer Kowalski. He's got a famous wrestling school in Massachusetts. And one late night, she calls him. And after an awkward conversation, he says, $2,000, I'll train you. And she's on her way to his school the very next day. She wrote in her book, though, she's not very complimentary of Killer. We'll say that. She wrote about him. Just outside of the ring, an old man, mid-70s, wearing a gray hairpiece that's so cheap you can see the rubber curling up on the nape of his neck, is shouting into the face of this poor, reed-thin, 20-something kid with really bad skin. To drive this point home, the old man whacks the kid over the head with a phone book. Walter Kowalski demonstrating his people skills. Of course, not long after the book came out, Kowalski called her a liar and said, she's the biggest liar I've ever come across. A lot to unpack here. I don't hear a ton of people saying a lot of negative stuff about Killer Kowalski. I wonder.
And you won't.
Okay.
You won't hear it. It's not there. Walter is one of the most respected guys in all of wrestling. I mean, he was a national star in that era where becoming a national star made you a made man. I think Walter is an older guy, Conrad, as she pointed out, in the '70s. I'm not sure how old he was at that time, but he was an older guy. Since when did China have any positive relationships with older men? He had three stepfathers, all older than her. That was a train wreck. All three of them,
right?
By her own admission. Right. And right. Then she gets raped by two guys. I'm assuming they might've been older than her. That would not be unusual based on her track record. So I think that she didn't trust older people, older men. She really didn't trust anybody, but especially did not trust older men. And that's what Walter Killer Kowalski represented to her. But if you talk to people that have been around wrestling a long time, longer than me, that were around Killer all in the Northeast and so forth. He was passionate. He would yell and things, but he was never violent. You know, he was just I found him to be one of the most engaging guys. Strange. Yeah. But think of his background. Think of his background. And anybody that's a lifer in pro wrestling, myself included, will have an issue or two here and there.
Yeah.
That's what it is. It's an insecure business. It breeds insecurity and it works on your self esteem and so forth. And it worked on it very negatively with Joni. But, I read this book years ago, I thought when I got to the part about Killer being so negative and not being quote unquote a good person, it kind of took me out of the moment. Like I said, well, I know this is not accurate, at least in my eyes. Maybe it isn't hers, but if this is inaccurate, then what else is inaccurate? So well, I don't know when Paul O'Brien and I were riding Under the Black Hat and finishing Slobber Knocker. That was the key thing. Our book is going to be factually accurate. And I need to make sure we stress what's my opinion and what isn't, what's factual or whatever, but everything's got to have a basis of truth. If you're writing a book about your life and you want your life to be either as controversial to sell books and to show that you came out on the other side whole or making yourself look good because of the pro wrestling insecurities that exist within your being. And she had that. We all have that.
Joni Lauer. Am I saying that right? Lauer. Joni, mm-hmm. Joan Marie Lauer, better known as China, born on December 27th, 1969, Rochester, New York. Tragedy is a big part of her life, JR. And if you know her story or you've read her book, you probably already know that. When was the first time you met Joni?
I think Triple H brought her to meet Vince. It might have been in Boston. Can't remember that far back, but I know the scenario was that she was a talent that was kind of from that New Hampshire area at that time. And she was socially involved with Triple H. She's trying to get in the wrestling business, very unique look. And I think Triple H gave Vince the idea to use her. And of course, Vince, being a smart booker, was trying to acquiesce to his top talents. And Hunter was not yet a quote unquote top guy, but he was heading that way. It was inevitable. So I think maybe at an event, and before she had her jaw realignment surgery, and even after, quite frankly, but before, she was had a very distinctively different look, in addition to being all jacked up and muscular and so forth, strong. So I think that was the first time. And she was intriguing. I mean, she was one of those kind of talents that the first time you lay eyes on her, you knew that this is a very unique talent and there's nobody quite like her that I've seen. And there wasn't before or after, quite frankly. But nonetheless, I think that was it. And good scouting by Triple H. Plus he got his girlfriend on the road with him. Not bad. So it worked out.
Yeah, it did work out.
Hey, it's Conrad Thompson. Thanks for checking out the podcast here on YouTube. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell so you get a notice anytime we upload some new content. And go save yourself some money right now. If you're in a 30-year loan or you have credit card debt, it's not a matter of if I can save you money. It's a matter of how much. Find out right now for free at SaveWithConrad.com. Hey, it's Conrad Thompson. Thanks for checking out the podcast here on YouTube. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell so you get a notice anytime we upload some new content. And go save yourself some money right now. If you're in a 30-year loan or you have credit card debt, it's not a matter of if I can save you money. It's a matter of how much. Find out right now for free at SaveWithConrad.com.